bones ranch high on the dead oak tree.
Spooks arrive from the midnight freak.
Creepy creeps with eerie eyes.
Starts to shriek and harmonize.
Grimly ghosts start to socialize.
When you hear the knell of a requiem bell,
we're ghost game where spirits dwell.
Restless bones eat eerie lies.
Rise and spooks of every size.
That's my lost Duchess, painted on the wall, looking as if she were alive. I call that piece a wonder now. Frau Pandorf's hands worked busily a day, and there she sits. Strangers like you never pictured countenance, the depth and passion of its earnest glance. But to myself they turn, since none puts by the curtain that I have drawn for you, but I, and see, as they would ask if they durst, how such a glance came there. So, not the first are you to ask thus. Sir, 'twas not her husband's presence only that called that spot of joy in the Duchess's cheek. Or perhaps Frau Pandorf chanced to say,
her mantle laps over my lady's wrist too much,
or
a paint must never hope to capture that faint half-flush that dies along her throat.
Such stuff was courtesy, she thought, and cause enough for calling up that spot of joy. She had a heart, how shall I say, too soon made, too easily impressed. She liked whate'er she looked on, and her looks went everywhere. Sir, 'twas all one. My favor at her breast, the dropping of the daylight in the west, the bough of cherry some officious fool broke for her in the orchard, the white mule she rode with round the terrace, all and each drew from her alike the approving speech, or blush at least. She thanked men, good, but thanked somehow, I know not how, as if she ranked my gift of a 900-year-old name with that of anybody's gift. Who'd stoop to blame this sort of trifling, even if you had the skill in speech, which I have not, to make your will quite clear to such a one, to say just this or just that in you disgusts me, or here you miss, or there exceed the mark. And if she let herself be lessened so, nor plainly set her wits to yours, forsooth, and made excuse, in then there'd be some stooping, and I choose never to stoop. Oh, sir, she smiled, no doubt, whene'er I bow. But who parts without much the same smile? This grew. I gave commands. And then old smiles stopped together. There she stands, as if alive. Will it please you rise? We'll meet the company below. I repeat, the Count, your master's known munificence is ample warrant that no just pretense of mine for dowry will be disallowed, though your fair daughter's self, as I avowed at starting, is my object. Nay, we'll go together now.